Welcome everyone. As you may know, this is selections from our permanent collection. We have this amazing, rich permanent collection here at school. These pieces were gathered again across both campuses, and we had a committee that kind of voted for which ones should be here. And that vote, was more focused on historical significance. Let's go to Albert Einstein. So, walking around the campus looking for things, and this catches my eye. And I look, and I go up to it, and I go, let me get in a little closer. And the first thing I read is the signature, which has the middle name, a maiden name of Spaeth, which I happen to know is a big family here in Chestnut Hill and in Philadelphia. Carola Spaeth, Hauschka, drew this charcoal of Albert Einstein in Princeton in 1935. And I'm like, oh, okay, that's kind of cool. And she wrote A. Einstein. Okay, so she just identifying who it is. And then I walk away. And then I walk back and I look at the other one. To my friends at Chestnut Hill Academy, A. Einstein. This is an original portrait by Carola Spaeth Hauschka of Albert Einstein that is dedicated to our school and signed by him not once, but twice. This is a piece by a group, a gentleman, his name is Tim Rollins. He was a conceptual artist, actually 70s, 80s, 90s. Tim Rollins actually had this huge group of rotating students, kids, mostly from the South Bronx, and he called them the Kids of Survival. Tim Rollins wanted everybody to know that it was never all done by him. So this is, it hung in the library, and it's apropos because it's the pages of Metamorphosis by Franz Kafka. And I won't go too much deeper, but this apple is real, and the apple is meant to rot in the piece, and it's meant to be replaced. However, that's really not realistic. But I popped out the fake apple, and I put the real apple in just to demonstrate how art is meant to decay. We have all alumni right here. This is like the alumni corner. Sandra Olswain, class of 1955. Victoria McNeil Levine, class of 75. Judy Jarvis, class of 77. These are both current painters and very well known. Both of those you've probably never seen because they hang in the Jennings House, in the permanent collection of Jennings House. Yes, Barbara Crawford. Many of you might remember that in November we came upon a really exciting find of five Crawford paintings that had been rolled up in the sauna closet behind us. And this was the first one. It's so hot back there, so if you're ever really cold. So this is a Barbara Crawford painting that's new to us. I just had it stretched and cleaned and framed. It's probably going to go to the lower school, the new lower school. So this, if you've never been in the girls' middle school library, then you might not have seen this. This was a residency by Leo Sewell, who is extraordinarily well known, and he is a Philadelphia-based sculptor. If you've ever been to the Please Touch Museum, there is a 40-foot tall Statue of Liberty torch, and that is Leo's work. So he came and did a residency in 2005 and left us with Springside Scotty.
Which is made up of toys that the kids brought in and he assembled them.
I'm sure if you've ever walked through here and seen the wall drawings, these are the Solowit wall drawings. They are, this is one of the largest collections of wall drawings by Solowit in the country. That's not confirmed, but I'm pretty sure it's true. We thought this was a Solowit. It is a Solowit. Okay, so it is a Solowit. So I found out when I went up there today and read the didactic for the first time, it was actually created by a gentleman named, one of the three named people on it is Tristan Lowe, who's a local sculptor. This is Joseph L. Castle III. He was also an alum here, an alumnus, and he's a very well-known sculptor. This is a bronze that he donated to the school in 2003 after he was in a show here. And I just found out that he's actually gifting another piece to the school in the next X amount of months. There will be a new piece of Joseph Castle's at a little garden outside of the McCausland building. So I think that's it.
Yes.
Wonderful. Yeah, and if anybody has any questions, feel free to stop me.
Bravo.
Yes.
And thank you.